Hi again, everyone. Mike Conrad here, founder of Aqueous Technologies and host of the Reliability Matters podcast with you once again for more tips and tricks for cleaning circuit assemblies. So, like so many other assemblers, you've come to the point where you need to clean at least some of your circuit assemblies. My experience tells me there's two common scenarios. Scenario number one, your facility hasn't cleaned assemblies since the ban on popular cleaning solvents back in the 90s. Rumor tells you that 111 trichloroethane or Freon and vapor degreasers were the solvents and machines of choice back in the day. That day is long gone. Scenario number two was the rumor that an extremely long inline water-based cleaner was used to remove water-soluble flux. That ship, while it hasn't sailed too far away, did leave the dock. In either scenario, many assemblers who enjoyed the cleaning reprieve provided by the invention of so-called no-clean flux back in the late 80s are now seeking a cleaning process. In many instances, modern cleaning knowledge is lacking. Let's bring your cleaning knowledge up to date when we return in just a moment. When it comes to modern cleaning or defluxing methods, there are a hierarchy of choices. The first choice is to use a water-based cleaning process or a solvent-based cleaning process. The next choice is to choose either a batch or conveyorized, frequently referred to as an inline cleaning process. If your choice is a solvent-based cleaning process, your equipment choice will undoubtedly be batch, a batch process of some type. While solvent was the cleaning media king prior to the 1990s, in modern times, solvents have been relegated mostly to rework and repair. The current cleaning media king of the forest is aqueous. When I refer to aqueous, I'm not suggesting a water-only cleaning process. Rather, I'm referring to a water with a water-based cleaning additive that allows the removal of both polar and nonpolar, water-soluble and non-water-soluble residue species. Assuming an aqueous cleaning media is chosen, the equipment choices are batch or conveyorized, aka inline. Both batch and conveyorized equipment provide equal cleaning capabilities. According to the IPC document, IPC CH65B, Guidelines for Cleaning of Printed Circuit Boards and Assemblies, batch is the most common cleaning equipment method used today. So which cleaning equipment method should be selected for your application? The answer is based on several factors. One factor is throughput. Another is real estate, how much space is available on your production floor for the machine. Another is the physical environment where the machine will go, and of course, your budget. Let's begin with throughput. Over the past several years, circuit assemblies have become more difficult to clean. In the past, conveyorized or inline cleaning machines operated at speeds up to 4 to 5 feet per minute. That high speed yielded impressive throughput numbers. Modern circuit assemblies, reflowed with higher temperature lead-free alloys and populated with very low standoff component heights, especially bottom terminated components, now frequently operate at substantially lower conveyor speeds, closer to 0.5 foot to 1 foot per minute. This changes the throughput rate considerably. Let's look at one example. If your conveyorized cleaner is 23 feet long, a size that's large enough for adequate cleaning, it will take 46 minutes for the first assembly to reach the end of the machine. Even fast speeds of 1 foot per minute produces the first clean assembly only after a 23-minute wait time. If your cleaning application is on the typical side, it would consist of high product mix with lower product volumes. In this scenario, a conveyorized machine may not keep up with your throughput and demands. A high-speed batch format cleaning machine can produce full loads of clean assemblies within 30 to 40 minutes, about the same time it takes for the first assembly to exit a conveyorized machine. Now let's talk about the physical environment where the machine will be located. A conveyorized cleaning machine with sufficient length to produce clean assemblies requires about 23 feet of floor space. Add to that the space required for the multiple carbon and resin beds required to feed the machine's insatiable appetite for deionized water, and add more space. The conveyorized cleaning machines are extremely loud, frequently requiring hearing protection in the immediate area around the machine. Most conveyorized cleaning machines require access to a drain for water isolation between the wash and rinse sections, and, if not closed loop, a drain for rinse water as well. Frequently, there is no accessible floor drain in the immediate area, so a pumping station is often required, requiring even more space. Now let's compare batch format cleaning machines. The average size of a batch format cleaning machine is about 17 square feet compared to about 120 square feet for an average conveyorized cleaner. Just the cleaner, not including the carbon and resin media and a pumping station. Now consider the peripheral equipment required for a batch machine. On average, just 2 to 3 media tanks are required. As for drain requirements, many batch format cleaning machines operate completely zero discharge, eliminating the need for a floor drain or a pumping station. Batch machines are exceptionally quiet, eliminating the need for any type of hearing protection. Finally, let's discuss the budget requirements. Show me the money. On average, the cost of a batch format cleaning machine is less than 25% of the cost of a decent conveyorized counterpart. Now factor in operating costs. Many conveyorized cleaning machines will consume as much as $70,000 worth of chemical annually. The cost of chemicals with many batch cleaners averages just 7% of the cost of conveyorized cleaners. The volume of water required on many conveyorized cleaners is as much as 600,000 gallons per year, compared with 500 gallons per year on many closed-loop cleaners, which just represents evaporative loss, not water down the drain. So, are batch format cleaning machines for everyone? Of course not. There are legitimate applications where conveyorized cleaning technologies make more sense. After all, it's all about the numbers. Before you make any decision on the preferred cleaning method, consider your specific throughput requirement now and into the future. Consider the real amount of space both required and available, including all of the possible peripheral devices required for proper equipment operation. Consider factors including chemical, water, DI media, and electrical costs, and most importantly, consider the environmental impact that any cleaning process may produce. I hope you found this topic helpful. Please keep your questions and topic suggestions coming. Send them to conrad@aqueoustech.com. Be sure to subscribe to receive new episode notifications. We release new episodes on the second and fourth Tuesday of each month. Also, if you're in the electronic assembly industry, be sure and attend. It's happening right now. Today's the first day of SMTAI, Surface Mount Technology International. And like most events, this too is virtual. I will be teaching a 3.5-hour professional development course on Friday, October 16th at 8:30 a.m. Pacific time. The course is entitled Tips and Tricks for Cleaning Circuit Assemblies. We'll dive into the weeds, as we always do, on cleaning. Visit smta.org and follow the links to SMTAI to register for that professional development course. Thanks again for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy, and we'll see you again very soon.